Liebe Choicer, schön sind ihr da. Bei mir auf dem Home Run Sofa ist heute Chris Wicki. Und das wird gerade jetzt dann alle in die Herzen höher schlagen lassen. Weil das ist nämlich der Leadsänger von Faves, einer Schweizer Indie-Rockband. Hi Chris.
Hello Petra.
I'm glad to have you here.
I am very glad to be here too. Es freut mich sehr, hier zu sein.
Oh. Er kann Deutsch. Where are you from originally?
Meine Mutter ist Ami von Connecticut, Hartford, Connecticut. Eine sehr arme Stadt in den USA. Und she flew to Europe when she was 17 and never came back to America. Because she hates America.
Your brother was in a band too, mm-hmm. called Chewy. Was
Absolutely.
There a competition between you and him?
At first, yes, because I was older than he was, and he stole all my records, and then had a better band than mine, which was totally pissed me off, of course. And then we got more or less on the same level, and we started touring internationally more or less at the same time, so it wasn't a competition anymore.
The songs of your new album are all in English, but the title is in French.
The title is a French expression, but it's used, it's like the only way you can say en garde when you're doing the sword fight. There's no other way of saying it. It's like, it comes from a time when French was the main language of the world. And I like the fact that once, a long time ago, the French-speaking people were like the most powerful people in the world. If we had been doing this TV, exactly. It's like, dude, we used to be the shit. And now, I mean, if we had been doing this TV interview in the alten Zeiten, we would be speaking French because that was like the main language. And it's just a little reminder of, you know, nowadays everybody speaks English, but in the days French, we used to, you know, be the guys.
You like French more than English?
No, I don't. The big problem with French is that it's spoken by the French people, and I generally don't have a great tenderness towards the French people.
You have also a label, Faves label. There are artists like Sophie Hunger and the Young Gods. Mm-hmm. Is there a competition between each other?
I think not everybody should have great success, or I think the level of success is adequate for a band like us. We sell a few records, we get in the charts, which I find sort of amazing every time, but we do. And we play for like 300, 400 people when we play in Switzerland, about the same in Germany. That's perfect. For me, we deserve this and we got it. For me, but Sophie Hunger has like this amazing, unique talent, and she deserves to be heard by as many people as possible. I think nobody should not like Sophie Hunger. So I think she should get to number one. That's also totally normal.
From the label to the love.
So this thing about people having to speak about their private lives, I disagree with it. Heidi Happy sings on our record, on our last record. I think she's a very talented person. And I'm extremely happy that I know Heidi Happy. And that's all I'm gonna say.
So do you think it's better to date a musician if you are a musician yourself?
If the musician happens to be Heidi Happy, yeah, in that case, yes, definitely.
The producer of your new album is Andrew Sheps. Mm-hmm. A great man. He was working with U2, Johnny Cash, Red Hot Chili Peppers. So how did you meet each other?
He was friends with a band from Norway called Motorcycle. We were on the same record label as Motorcycle. Motorcycle gave him all the records of that record label as a present, and that was 10 years ago. And he liked our records very much, and then kept buying them when the new ones came out. And a year and a half ago, he said, I would like to work with some European bands, because they always work with American bands. And so he contacted like us and I think Deus and a few other bands to work with them. And he flew over to Europe and he did like a small European tour of bands. And we got along extremely well. It's really important to get along well with the producer. And after a weekend, we were already good friends. And so we decided to do it with him, because I think it's flattering to have a fan that is also the producer of the Red Hot Chili Peppers. I think it's cool. I like it.
Do you want to impose younger artists with a man like him?
Yeah, exactly. That's the reason why we did it.
I think. Okay.
No, it's the thing is with these guys, he's more or less working at the highest level you can work in rock music. And if you record Johnny Cash, you've got one of the best singers of all times, and if you do something right with him and you learn, you know, the way Johnny Cash does it, where he puts his voice compared to his microphone, what he does to make himself sound good, you learn tons of stuff. Because Johnny Cash had been doing this for 50 years, he knew exactly what he was doing, and Andrew would be like watching, like, oh, this is how Johnny Cash does it. And that kind of experience you can only get with somebody who worked with those kind of people. So we were never going to say no to him, because then he taught us stuff that Johnny Cash had taught him, and you know, when we're 70, we'll teach it to other people. It's part of that long line of history in rock music, and it's really cool to be able to learn from people who have worked with the best people around.
You have your guitar here.
Yes, I do.
Maybe you want to play something from your new album, but I know you don't like it to play in interviews, so feel free. You can do with your guitar whatever you want.
So I have this guitar here, and I left it on the floor hoping that he would walk on it with his camera. Obviously, it did not happen, so now I have to play something. So you're going to walk around with me.
With the microphone.
Yeah, you're going to take this microphone and walk around with me.
The cameraman. We can do that.
So stay in front of me, put the microphone in front of the guitar.
And then have the camera.
Yeah, you're great. You look great. What's your name?
Michael
was his name. He works for Joyce. Joyce is a wonderful TV internet station. It's filled with Max and filled with young people that make me feel very old. So you, for example, what is your name? Sounds really cool. What is my name? It's boring old Christian. See? That's why young people are so much cooler than old ones. This is a tour of Joyce. I can't pronounce that name. I'll try it once again.
It's Joyce.
It's Joyce.
Welcome back, Johnny Cash from Lausanne. Your tour starts at February 18th.
Yes, correct. Yeah.
Do you like the life on tour?
So in Switzerland, it's not really life on tour. You play only weekends. It's perfect. Mm-hmm. It's really great. You work on the week and then you go play on weekends. It's wonderful. But we decided that every year it would be nice to have like 20 days on tour, a real tour. Like, so we do Germany end of April, we do 10 days, and then we might do either the USA in September or Europe in September, October, something like that. But, and then the rest is Switzerland, because it's so close and so practical and so nice to play.
Sichert euch das Ticket und geht die Band schauen, es ist wirklich super. Wir sind auch schon wieder am Ende. Schön, habt ihr zugeschaut und hoffe bis zum nächsten Mal.